From Carnegie Hall in New York, Arturo Toscanini is conducting this concert by the NBC Symphony Orchestra. As the concluding work today, we're to hear pictures at an exhibition by the 19th century Russian composer Modest Mussorgsky in the familiar orchestral arrangement of Maurice Ravel. Mussorgsky, a member of the group known as the Russian Five, who after Glinka banded themselves together to create a nationalistic school of Russian writing, was considered by his contemporaries to be the least important composer of this group because of his unacademic approach in his composition. This disparity, as the years have proved, was not the lack of formal education in music nor the inability to conform because of ignorance, but apparently his complete originality, surviving even the worst attempts of his friends to reorchestrate and rewrite his scores after his passing. The pictures referred to in the work we're to hear, Pictures at an Exhibition, are 10 paintings by a friend of the composer, Viktor Hartmann, an architect and artist, which Mussorgsky saw in the gallery exhibition after Hartmann's death. As a memorial, then, to his friend, Mussorgsky composed this work for piano, but it is more familiarly known in the brilliant orchestration done many years later by Maurice Ravel. As a preface to the first picture and connecting the others, as far as the fifth, there is the theme of a promenade, a self-portrait of the composer going from one picture to another along the walls of the gallery. The pictures in their order are the Gnome, Il Vecchio Castello, the Tuileries, Bydlo, the Ballet of Chicks in Their Shells, the Two Jews of Saint-Denis, the Marketplace at Limoges, the Catacombs, the Hut on Fowl's Legs, and finally, the Great Gate at Kiev. Arturo Toscanini has now resumed his place on the podium and conducts the NBC Symphony in Mussorgsky's Pictures at an Exhibition. massive musical architecture of the including chords in the last section of this work, the Great Gate at Kiev. Mussorgsky's Pictures at an Exhibition has been the concluding work in today's concert by Arturo Toscanini and the NBC Symphony Orchestra. Earlier in the program, we heard Maestro Toscanini conduct the NBC Symphony and the Symphony No. 94 in G, the Surprise Symphony of Franz Joseph Haydn. Maestro Toscanini had retired to the wings. Here he is again, receiving the applause of this audience, which en masse has risen to express their affection for him personally, as well as their admiration of the music which they heard. There's continuing scattered applause in the audience, and most of the ladies and gentlemen present don't want to leave. They want to see Maestro again. He's retired to the wings while the men in the orchestra wait on the stage, and perhaps he will come forward again. We've had an ovation here in Carnegie Hall, which Maestro Toscanini has received in his usual modest and self-effacing manner and signaled to the men of the orchestra that they should receive the plaudit that is being given. Next week at this time, Maestro Toscanini will conduct the orchestra in a program including the Manfred Overture of Robert Schumann, the wedding dance, the Passo Assai, from Act One of Rossini's opera William Tell, and the Symphony in E Minor, Symphony from the New World, of Antonín Dvořák. This program, 2 weeks from today, will include the Symphony No. 7 of Franz Schubert, and the prelude to the Meistersinger by Richard Wagner, and 3 weeks from today, we will have an all Debussy program. We cordially invite you to be with us next week and in successive weeks over your favorite NBC station when the National Broadcasting Company again presents Arturo Toscanini and the NBC Symphony Orchestra. Today's program was heard in Canada over the facilities of the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation and was produced by Don Gillis. Your engineer was George Mathis. This is Ben Grauer speaking.